Hello students, next let us look at what are the elements in an AC circuit. This is the basic concept that will be used throughout the study of AC circuits. Now suppose if we are going to have a voltage source, we know that in AC source it is represented by a sinusoidal wave, and suppose we write it as phi cos 200 t. Now from this, what you should understand is that in general it is always written as some value V, capital V, that is the main amplitude, then cos omega t. This means that here V is 5 and omega is 200, from which we know that omega is 2 pi f frequency, from which I can find out the frequency as 200 divided by 2 pi, which gives me 100 by pi. Not that I am interested to find out, I am just giving a information. Now what is important here is to understand that this can be written as 5 angle 0 degree. Why 0 degree? Because there is nothing in addition to this. Generally, if you are having something of this form, let's say plus minus V cos omega t minus theta, then this we will basically write it as V, whatever be the value, whether it is plus or minus, it does not matter. Plus or minus, it does not matter. We will always write this part as positive value only, because that is the magnitude part, okay? So, plus V angle, whatever is the angle that is here. So, here it is minus theta, so here we will write as minus theta. This already I have taught you in phases, and I have also taught you if instead of cos it is going to be sine, what will you write. If you are not sure about it, go back to that video and learn it, because without that it is impossible to solve AC circuits. Okay, so this is how you generally write polar form. We always have to convert things into complex numbers, otherwise we will never be able to do it. Similarly, even the current source is also written as the phasor form, let's say 2 angle 90 degrees. Either it will be written like this, or it will be written as 2 cos omega t plus 90 degrees. Or there may be even a value of omega, that means it may be written as 2 cos, let's say the value of omega is 5, so 5 t plus 90 degree. Whether it will be written in this form, we always have to find out and write it in phasor form, always. Okay, now if we are writing this in phasor form, I can always write its rectangular form. We have already studied how to do polar to rectangular conversion, so I can always write it in rectangular form. Now coming to the other elements, for example resistor. A resistor is always written as R itself. So this is the element, so let me write the heading. So this is the element, and what I am interested in is finding out the impedance. And with impedance, let us also introduce something called as admittance. Okay, admittance. So generally, impedance is always represented as Z. So Z, in case of a resistor, Z will be equal to R itself. Real value, no imaginary value, only real value. Similarly, the impedance admittance is always represented as Y, which is basically 1 by Z, or in our case, since it's a resistor, I will just write 1 by R. Let's take the next element. The next element is an inductor. The inductor is having a inductance of L Henry's. Okay, it is in Henry's, which is also written as, in short, as capital H. So it may be some 10 Henry's, or maybe even 2 Henry's, or maybe even 0.25 Henry's. Its value may be anything based on problem to problem. The impedance of the inductor is always written as Z is equal to J, for our imaginary value J, omega L. Now what is omega? Omega is the frequency that we have written here. That means wherever this L is connected, that circuit will have a source, and that source will have some frequency omega. That omega we have to write here, multiplied with L. L is the inductance value that we have got. Okay, so this is how we will write. So the impedance is going to be J omega L, and the admittance Y will be the Z inverse, or 1 by Z, which is going to be 1 divided by J omega L. Okay, since J is in denominator, I can bring it in numerator by writing it as, if it is in denominator, it is plus. When I take it to numerator, it becomes minus. If it is minus in the numerator, if I take it on top, it will become negative. It will become positive. So here, since it is positive in the denominator, when I take it to the numerator, it will become minus J divided by omega L. I can write it like this also. Some people also write it as minus of 1 by omega L J. It's all one and the same thing. Generally, the terminology that we use is this. Okay. The next element is capacitor. So if we are having a capacitor C, it's always written in farads. For example, 10 microfarads. 10 microfarads can also be written as 10 into 10 raised to power micro is minus 6. So 10 into 10 raised to power minus 6 farads. Or we can even write 2 millifarad. What is milli? Milli is 2 into 10 raised to power. Milli stands for minus 3 farads. Or it can be even, you know, very small value like 0.2 nanofarad. Nano stands for 10 raised to power minus 9. Or it can be, let's say, 15 picofarads. Pico stands for 10 raised to power minus 12. This one stands for 10 raised to power minus 9, nano. Okay, so generally it will be in micro or even in milli or just simply farads. Okay, so what is the impedance of that capacitor? The impedance of that capacitor is 1 divided by J omega C, or it is sometimes also written as, by taking J on top, minus J divided by omega C. And what is going to be the admittance? The admittance is going to be 1 by Z. So if I take the inverse of it, I will get basically J omega C. So why did I write admittance and why did I write impedance? Generally, we will be only interested in, you know, impedance. Generally, we are only interested in impedance. Admittance in certain cases, when the need arises, when the problem comes, I will tell you. But generally, almost 95% we will be using impedance for our calculation. Okay, so now, why we have studied all of this? We have studied all of this because we want to do a conversion. Okay, we have to always do a conversion of the AC circuit into complex numbers so that we can solve. Now, there is something that I want you to understand very much here. See, up till now the resistance value was, constant. That is not changing. So if you are having 10 ohms, whatever be the circuit, the impedance is always going to be 10 ohms. There is going to be no change. So up till now in DC, we already only had resistance, which had a fixed value. But now the change is going to come when we are going to have inductor and capacitor. Because as soon as an inductor or a capacitor comes, the equation is this, where the omega value is going to be the frequency. That is going to decide what is going to be the value of Z. So if you are having a 10, if you are having a 10 Henry inductance, its value will be different at 1 Hertz, and at 10 Hertz it will be something else, at 100 Hertz its value of impedance will be something else. So its value will keep on changing with different frequency. Why? Because the equation of impedance is omega and L, where omega stands for frequency. So as the frequency changes, the impedance offered by the same inductance will be different. Same is the case with capacitor, because it depends always on frequency. And this is where I want to say why we didn't have L and C in DC circuit. Just have a very clear understanding in this. If suppose I am going to take an inductor. An inductor can be written in its impedance as, as impedance, it will be J omega L. So if suppose the omega value, so let me take a value, let me take L is equal to 10 Henry. So the value of Z should be equal to J omega 10, J omega 10. Now based on the value of omega, the value of Z is going to vary. So if omega is 10, the value of Z will be J omega is 10, 10 into 10 is going to be 100. Okay, if it is going to be, let's say 50, then it's going to be J 50 into 10, which is going to be 500. Now if I am going to go for very high frequencies, let's say I am going to go for 10 raised to power 6, then it becomes J into 10 raised to power 6 into 10 is going to be 10 raised to power 7. So the value is very, very high. The impedance value is very, very, very high. So that means when the impedance value is very, very high, it will not allow any current to pass through it. So it's as good as an open circuit, where when it is high frequency. Whereas when it is very low frequency, suppose if omega is equal to, let me, you know, change this a bit. If suppose I am going to write omega and Z little bit on top. If omega is equal to 0, then the value of Z is going to be equal to 0 into 10 is going to be 0. So it is as good as writing J 0, or basically it is 0. If the impedance is 0, that means all the current is going to pass through. That means it is as good as short circuit. So in DC, DC is when we are having no frequency, isn't it? DC means direct current. Direct current means no frequency. Frequency is 0. That means omega is equal to 0. So in DC, the inductor is basically acting, going to act as a short circuit. So is there any point in connecting an inductor in DC circuit? No. Why? Because it will act as a short circuit. There is no point. So that is why we never used inductor in the case of a DC circuit. Now, same way, let's take the case of a capacitor. In the case of a capacitor also, whatever be the capacitance value, let us say that it is going to be, let me say 10 raised to power or 10 millifarads. The impedance is going to be minus J divided by omega C. If suppose C is 10 microfarad, then I will write as minus J 1 divided by omega C. C I will is 10 milli. 10 milli is how much? 10 into 10 raised to power minus 3. Okay. This 10 into 10 raised to power minus 3 will be 10 raised to power minus 2. If I take it on top, this will become 10 raised to power minus 2 from denominator. If I take it to the numerator, it will become 10 raised to power 2 pi omega. Okay. So, this is the impedance. Now, let me form the omega and the impedance for the case of capacitor. Okay. We have already discussed for the case of inductor. Let's look at for the case of capacitor. So, in the capacitor, if the omega value is going to be 0, see, look, if the denominator here is going to be 0, then Z value is going to be minus J infinity. That means infinite impedance. This is going to offer infinite impedance. Infinite impedance means nothing is going to pass through. In that case, this is going to act as a open circuit. When it is zero frequency. When does zero frequency occur? In case of DC. So, in DC, the capacitor acts as an open circuit. Now, if I am going to increase the frequency to, let's say, 10, then it will become minus J and 10 raised to power 2 divided by 10, it will become 10. So, minus J 10. If I am going to put 100, then it is going to be minus J. If I am going to put 1000, this is going to be minus J 10 raised to power minus 1. If I am going to put, suppose, 10 raised to power 9, high frequency, very high frequency, it is going to be, see here it was minus J 10 raised to power minus 1 is 0.1. Okay. So, if I am going to put omega is equal to 10 raised to power 9, then you can imagine it is going to be J 10 raised to power 2 divided by 10 raised to power 9. If I take 10 raised to power 9 on top, it will become 10 raised to power minus 9. So, it becomes minus J 10 raised to power 2 into 10 raised to power minus 9, which becomes minus J 10 raised to power minus 7, which is very, very small. So, very, very small impedance means the current, whatever you are going to give, it is going to pass through this. So, it is as good as short circuit. So, in very high frequency, the capacitor acts as a short circuit. See how they are totally different. An inductor in DC acts as a short circuit, whereas in high frequency it will act as open circuit. Similarly, a capacitor is opposite. In DC it will act as open circuit, and in high frequency it will act as short circuit. This fact you should never forget. Similarly, these equations also you should never forget. Okay. Next, we will see how we will convert an AC circuit into something that can be solved.